fly a lot. I like planes. I was on a plane the other day, and I was wondering, are there keys to the plane? Do they need keys to start the plane?
There are keys to the plane. These are the keys. And it's a beautiful day, because there's no airplanes in the hangar. Let's go flying.
Clear prop!
Test 1-2.
Alright, I got you. Can you hear me?
I got you loud and clear.
Awesome.
Houston Center, roger.
Hook summation Charlie, 2153 Zulu, wind 130 at 8. Visibility 10, few clouds 4000. Temperature 212.11, altimeter 3012. Localizer, runway 17 right in use. Notice to airman, taxiway Kilo north of taxiway Echo closed. Taxiway Foxtrot between taxiway Hotel and taxiway Lima closed. Discussion for directive in the airfield about advise and under contact. You have information, Charlie.
So I heard the approach. Does that mean we're going to depart 17 right as well?
Yeah.
Okay. Hooks ground, Skyhawk 1-966 Foxtrot. And United looking to taxi for a VFR departure to the west with information, Charlie.
November 1-966 Foxtrot, Hooks ground, Delta ramp, taxi via Juliet Echo Papa.
Juliet Echo Papa to the Delta ramp, Skyhawk 66 Foxtrot.
Cleared for takeoff, traffic 1 mile final.
See the traffic on a 1 mile final, we're cleared for takeoff 17 right, Skyhawk 66 Fox.
With your air Delta traffic departing prior to your arrival.
Alright, keep flying across west direction when we get onto the runway.
Okay, it's going to be ailerons to the right.
Number 920 Delta Sierra Hook, start roger.
Full ailerons to the right.
So you'll start off all the way, to the left.
Oh, to the left, right, yeah. Coming that way, okay.
You can go ahead and start throttling up. And then as you gain speed, you'll just slowly kind of bring it out.
Okay.
So stalls and any maneuvers You have to be at an area where you can recover no less than 1,500 HEL.
Okay.
So at 2,000 here, we're above 1,500 HEL. But the ground here is 300. So we're pretty good.
And then the airplane, kind of the reverse L, would be checking both, mixture in, lights on.
Yep.
Is that pretty much it, I guess?
Pretty much. So I think the best way to do steep turns. Steep turns are kind of easiest to do when you have a good reference outside.
Okay.
Everyone likes to pretend like, oh, pick a heading, that's easy. It's like, no, pick something outside, because then you can fudge it just a little bit, too. I just kind of point towards that. It looks like it's almost directly north anyways.
Like that lake or whatever? And that little path?
Yeah, so as long as we do this kind of quickly and don't get too close to it.
Okay.
So, obviously steep turns, 45 degrees, left or, the left or right roll.
Do you want to demonstrate first?
Do you want me to?
Yeah, if you don't mind.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, my controls?
Your controls.
Cool. We're pointing to that lake right now. We're set up in cruise. We're actually at 90, which is kind of a perfect speed. We're going to go ahead and go into this. As I start rolling to the left, because we know the area is clear, as I pass this 30 degree mark, I'm going to add just a little bit of touch of power and a little bit of back pressure, all the way to 45 degrees. I'm looking outside, I want the horizon to kind of cross a line for me on the engine cowling, and you kind of can see where that is. And I'm just going to hold the airplane in this attitude. I'm not using trim or anything, I'm just holding it with my hand. Every now and then I'm checking inside, looking at the attitude, making sure I'm still at 2,000 feet as I'm just coming around. I'm making sure every now and then too that I'm coordinated on the rudder. I kind of feel I'm going a little too high, so I'm just going to release a little bit of pressure. And it's going to pull a little bit of pressure back. And I see that lake. As it comes in my field of view, I'm just going to roll out a little bit. So I'm pointing the nose right there, and I'm just going to push a little more forward pressure and pull back on the power a little bit. The airplane has a tendency to kind of balloon up as you give it a little more power when you come out of the roll.
Okay.
The key thing, this is actually a little kind of loose. I don't know how tight you can get that. The key kind of thing in this is try not to over-control and try not to under-control. Which kind of sounds funny as you see that, but if you have a really good entry from a stable thing, so like right now the airplane's kind of cruised out, you can see if I let it go, it's staying right at 2,000.
Yeah.
So the airplane's really stable right now, so going into it, I'm not fighting the airplane.
Okay.
Always make sure the airplane's kind of nice and stable before going into it. Unfortunately, we're going to get really close to that lake,
yeah.
Which might be a little problem. I can see a farm kind of off in the distance, too. So, we can still use that, or we
okay.
can use that if you want.
That was good. I mean, I still kind of see that path or whatever.
Okay. The key is when it's far off ahead of you, you can really get the nose pointed towards it.
Okay.
Because you want to try to limit yourself. You want to try to be pointing within about 10 degrees of whatever point you pick. But yeah, the key thing is kind of have that good entry. Doesn't need to be super fast going into it, but it needs to just came nice and smooth. Once you hit 30 degrees, which is that big, that first thick line,
yeah.
Add just a little touch of power, usually about 100 RPMs, and pull just a little back on the yoke. And keep it all the way coming to about 45, which is right between those two lines, or whatever you feel like 45 is for the most part. I mean, technically, at VFR flying, you don't even have to have an attitude indicator.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
Try to do it with as little looking as inside, so once you get that angle, if you look at the attitude indicator, once you get that 45 angle, look at where the horizon crosses on your engine.
And hold the nose there.
And then hold the nose there. And then periodically, just keep glancing at your altitude, and if you see it's rising, release a little pressure on the yoke,
okay.
And if you see that it's falling, just pull back a little more on the yoke.
Okay.
Well, whenever you're ready, your controls again.
My controls.
I try to pick something off your nose to start this maneuver at.
It's like so much nothing out here. So
yeah.
Much generic nothing. I mean, kind of that white post or whatever else just off to the
yeah,
right.
That's okay. We've cleared the area, and I've kept a lookout. I haven't seen any other airplanes or anything, so if you want to turn over to that post over there.
Yeah, I'll go back to it.
Yeah, always start kind of point, facing
at your
point.
At your thing?
Yeah. It makes it easier too, because then you don't have to fight with where you were and everything.
Okay. Alright, so about a 030.
Yep.
Okay, I'm going to go into it, add a little power.
So just slowly start going into that. As you cross that 30, that's when you want to add some power, and then pull back a little bit on the yoke. Keep it right at 45 right there. And just kind of look where that crosses. You'll notice if you look at your altimeter, you're kind of falling, so just pull back a little bit more.
Okay.
Kind of keep that bank in there. And look, now it's kind of nice and stable.
Coordinated.
Look where that looks like outside, and just keep that sight picture outside. And you can tell where the horizon comes if you're looking outside, if you're falling or climbing.
Yep.
Like we're probably
looking
climbing.
At the ball too, so we're pretty coordinated.
Yeah, so we're a little high, but it's okay.
And there's the white post.
Pillar, and just trying to kind of roll out. If you need to, use a little bit of rudder to keep it kind of tight and coordinated. Perfect. Look at that. For your first time doing a steep turn, that was
That was pretty dang good.
Cool, that's right.
So what kind of things would we have to worry about? We talked about it a little bit for like emergency maneuvers and stuff, or emergency descents. Emergency procedures where like if we lost an engine, like what kind of things would we notice if we thought we were going to start losing the engine here in a second?
Like what would it start to sound and look like?
Yeah, like what would be a big one where we know we were going to lose the engine?
Probably the sound right away. We'd hear the engine roll back or whatever, or start choking or whatever you want to say.
Yeah. What if we saw fluids come out? What fluid might come out?
Oil?
Yeah. So that's a big one, and actually this happened up in Conroe at one point. They didn't tighten the oil dipstick enough, and it actually ended up flying out. And it siphoned all the oil out, because the air rushing over the top just siphoned all the oil out, and they had to abort their takeoff from it.
Wow.
That's a good reason to make sure those are tight.
So you'd see oil just coming up the cowling?
If you started seeing oil coming out of the cowling right now, what would you probably think?
I'd look at this, make sure, are we losing a lot of oil pressure?
And you see it slowly coming to zero.
Then the engine's going to seize up.
Yeah.
If it's like a car.
Yep. So what would you want to do in that case? The engine's about to seize up.
I'd say pull the mixture to idle.
Okay.
And then make sure I pitch for 65.
So we're not going to pull the mixture to idle, obviously, but we're going to pull the throttle to idle. So we've pulled the mixture to idle. We've killed the engine to try to protect the engine. There's a tower in front of us, so watch out for that.
Okay. Now we're going to pitch for 65 knots so we can get the most glide out of our... most bang for our buck here. I'm going fast, obviously. And then I'm going to start to immediately look for spots. I see a lot of clear area over there.
Yeah, so start that turn now so we don't get too close to that tower.
And I'm probably even looking right there. But that's back right into the wind too, so. Might have to do some kind of a slip. We're pretty high, but.
So actually, if you probably put flaps, you could probably get down to that field directly in front of us pretty easily.
Okay. And then I'm going to run through the emergency checklist, which I don't think I have on me right now. Oh, it's up here.
So remember, the emergency checklist is only if you have enough altitude.
Okay.
Otherwise, do a quick flow. In this case, we know that we've lost oil pressure. We're not going to be able to restart that engine, so we don't have to worry too much about a flow. In this case, next thing, step we want to do is what? We did ABC.
Oh, we're going to communicate to ATC, flip to a Houston approach frequency, and declare an emergency.
Or declare. It wouldn't necessarily be approach. It'd be 121.5.
Okay. Oh, guard, right.
Yeah. All right, let's go ahead. We're about 1,000 feet off the ground. Let's go ahead and start climbing back up. We'll climb back up to 2,000. You can go ahead and start turning the left back to a kind of a northbound heading.
Okay.
To full power, go full power climb, and just doesn't matter the altitude, just start climbing at a 60. Actually, I'm going to climb at 60. I think VX in this one is 62, I think is VX. So say we're doing a short field takeoff. We're climbing at 62. We're getting over an obstacle. Uh-oh, that engine just died.
Woo! Wow.
You know how fast we have to pitch it over just so we don't lose. So we don't stall and we don't lose that airspeed. It's something a lot of people don't think about. It's something a lot of people neglect to practice too, in my opinion.
At what point are you just going straight ahead? Is that 600 feet?
I tell people you go straight ahead until you get at least 1,000 feet.
Okay. Regardless, trees, whatever, you're going straight ahead?
Yeah, regardless. Okay. And if you're going for the trees, just try to crash into them as gently and as slowly as possible.
Would you try to throw some flaps down to slow yourself?
Oh yeah, I'd go as slow as possible if I knew I was absolutely going to hit trees.
Just try to put it in the top.
So if you actually lost your engine on your going on takeoff, it's about 30 degrees each side.
Okay.
And the reason is your wings produce lift, right?
Yeah.
And that lift goes basically, we'll say one direction. It goes straight down when we're level, right?
Right.
So if we start to turn, that lift is suddenly going sideways. Well, now it also has a horizontal and a vertical component, so it's not really lifting the plane up anymore.
So you're spending some altitude.
Yeah. So the other kind of thing we might have to do at some point is not only that gliding to land, but let's say you bought one of these cheap Chinese cameras or whatever, and all of a sudden the lithium ion battery on it just exploded, and all of a sudden the back's on fire.
Okay.
What would you want to do in that case?
Throw it out of the airplane.
Let's say it caught the back seat on fire, so the back seat of the aircraft is on fire right now.
I want to get the airplane down as soon as possible.
Yeah. open up the windows probably. Well, no, I'm going to feed the fire, I guess. I don't know. So what happens if you give too much air to a fire?
It gets bigger.
Not necessarily.
You blow it out?
Yeah, I mean, what about a birthday candle? You can blow out a birthday candle,
yeah.
Right? So, yes, air is fuel for fire, but also if you have a ton of air rushing over it, it might snuff the fire out, too.
Okay.
So especially, you open up the windows, and you go down almost close to VNO. So in this case, an emergency descent would be at about 120.
Okay. Literally, just get the altitude off as soon as you can.
Pretty much. So in this case, go ahead and put on carb heat, and when you're ready, just pitch forward and go down to 120 engine idle. And as you're doing this, you obviously want to find someplace in front of you to land, but... I am making sure the area is clear as we're doing this, so... Eventually you'll have to make sure the area is clear and everything, but you see, you get down fast. I mean, we're getting down at 1,100 feet per minute almost.
Right. So this would be like an emergency descent.
So this is an emergency descent, basically.